Hello guys, welcome to another video of mine. Today I'm here to show you how to connect a Raspberry Pi to your laptop. For that, first you need to connect your Raspberry Pi to a TV which has a HDMI option. So after connecting the HDMI of Raspberry Pi to the HDMI of your TV, now go to the terminal and type sudo raspi config. Press enter and now you get a window here. Go to interfacing options and press enter. Go to VNC and then press enter. It will ask you whether the server VNC server to be enabled or not. So navigate from the arrow keys and press S and again press enter. Then select, then go to finish and press enter. Now you must see a icon here where showing that the VNC is enabled. So now just to double check it, go to menu and go to preferences, Raspberry Pi configuration, and go to interfaces. Check whether it is enabled. If it is disabled, press enabled and click on OK. Since this is enabled, now we'll move on to connecting our Raspberry Pi to the laptop through the Ethernet cable. Okay, after you have enabled the VNC on your Raspberry Pi, now head on to your laptop, remove the HDMI connection and connect your Ethernet port of the Raspberry Pi to the Ethernet port of your laptop. Now head on to Google Chrome and download these two softwares, VNC Viewer and Advanced IP Scanner. In the VNC Viewer, download the 64-bit. If you have the 64-bit laptop, sadly it doesn't support the 32-bit version, so leave it to 64-bit and download the VNC Viewer. And now go to Advanced IP Scanner, press on the free download and click on the download latest version. Download the latest version.
Far Hippo now, and OBR are offering 13%.
Now go ahead and install this. Since I have it in my laptop, I'll just skip the step of the installation. Now what you got to do is connect the Raspberry Pi. Power up the Raspberry Pi now. Give it some time, it will boot up. Now start the Advanced IP Scanner. Okay, now yeah, give me 5 seconds, the Raspberry Pi is booting up. After the Raspberry Pi has booted up, just click on this scan button. It will scan all the networks that are connected to your laptop. As you can see, you should get a blue LCD screen here showing that it is connected, showing that the Raspberry Pi LAN connection is active. After it becomes blue, I think it is still booting up. Okay, wait for a time, I'll just pause the video. Or run the scan again. Maybe my Raspberry Pi wasn't booted up properly when I ran the scan the first time. I'm just trying it again. So you just have to first boot up your Raspberry Pi and then connect. Okay, yeah, see, I can see a blue LCD screen here showing that the connection is active. If this screen thing is gray, then the connection is not active. That is what it shows. So now note down this IP address. Okay, I'll just copy IP. Okay, and now you can pause the scan. Now click on VNC viewer, run, click on run. Now go to file, new connection, and paste the IP address here, and name it anything like Pi or something. Okay, click on OK. So now if you double click on this, it will prompt a dialog to give you the username and password. So for this authentication to happen, you must have VNC enabled on your Raspberry Pi, which I showed you earlier in this video. So the username will be Pi, and the password will be Raspberry. Okay, go ahead and click on OK, and yeah, boom, yeah, there it is. Okay, thank you guys for watching my video. If you like my content, just like this video and subscribe to my channel for more videos. I'll be uploading some more videos on Raspberry Pi.